Join us in praying the Holy Rosary for the intentions of the Holy Father and all the faithful, for our nation and the government leaders, for the sick and the dying, because of COVID-19, and for those who minister to them, and for all the souls in purgatory.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
The Glorious Mysteries. The first glorious mystery, the Resurrection. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
The second glorious mystery, the Ascension.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
The third glorious mystery, the coming of the Holy Spirit. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
The fourth glorious mystery, the Assumption of Mary into Heaven.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
The fifth glorious mystery, the coronation of Mary. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell,
and lead all souls to heaven, especially those in most need of thy mercy.
O Mary conceived without sin,
pray for us who have recourse to thee.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of mercy. Hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To you do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To you do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, your eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show us the blessed fruit of your womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
O God, whose only begotten Son, by his life, death, and resurrection, has purchased for us the rewards of eternal life, grant, we beseech you, that meditating upon these mysteries of the Most Holy Rosary of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we may imitate what they contain and obtain what they promise, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Behold the faithful and prudent servant,
whom the Lord has set over his household.
The Lord loved him and adorned him.
He clothed him with a robe of glory.
Let us pray.
We ask, O Lord, that we may be helped by the merits of the Holy Patriarch Joseph, spouse of your Most Holy Mother, so that what we cannot obtain by ourselves may be given to us through his intercession, who live and reign forever. Amen.
Oratio Imperata. God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest for those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition and our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin, Amen. Our Lady, Health of the Sick,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends in Christ, it is the third Sunday of Easter. We are indeed blessed to celebrate the Eucharist once again. And we continue to lift the world, our country, our families, all of us who are in need of God's love and mercy given this COVID-19 pandemic crisis. As we celebrate this Eucharist, I also invite you, our online participants, to pray with me, as also today we are celebrating this Mass for your intentions and also for the special intention of our dear Cristeta Vergara, our Lola Tita, whose urn is here, which I will bless after the prayer, after communion. And as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, we recognize our failings before God and before one another and ask for pardon and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
May your people exult forever, O God, in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope to the rejoicing of the day of resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "You who are Jews, indeed all of you staying in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to my words. You who are Israelites, hear these words. Jesus the Nazarene was a man commended to you by God with mighty deeds, wonders, and signs, which God worked through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This man delivered up by the set plan and foreknowledge of God, you killed, using lawless men to crucify him. But God raised him up, releasing him from the throes of death, because it was impossible for him to be held by it. For David says of him, 'I saw the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed. Therefore my heart has been glad, and my tongue has exulted. My flesh too will dwell in hope, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your Holy One to see corruption. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.'" My brothers, one can confidently say to you about the patriarch David that he died and was buried, and his tomb is in our midst to this day. But since he was a prophet and knew that God had sworn an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that neither was he abandoned to the netherworld, nor did his flesh see corruption. God raised this Jesus. Of this we are all witnesses, exalted and the right hand of God. He received the promise of the Holy Spirit from the Father and poured him forth as you see and hear. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Keep me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I say to the Lord, my Lord are you. O Lord, my allotted portion and my cup, you it is who hold fast my lot.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
I bless the Lord who counsels me. Even in the night, my heart exhorts him. I set the Lord ever before me. With him at my right hand, I shall not be disturbed.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
Therefore, my heart is glad and my soul rejoices. My body too abides in confidence, because you will not abandon my soul to the netherworld, nor will you suffer your faithful one to undergo corruption.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
You will show me the path to life, abounding joy in your presence, the delights at your right hand forever.
Lord, you will show us the path of life.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, if you invoke as Father him who judges impartially according to each one's works, Conduct yourselves with reverence during the time of your sojourning, realizing that you were ransomed from your futile conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with perishable things like silver or gold, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless and blemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Open the scriptures to us. Make our hearts burn while you speak to us.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus, and they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them. But their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleophas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people. How our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But we were hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described. But him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not easy that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all the scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them. And it happened that while he was with them at table, they took bread, said a blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that their eyes were opened and they recognized him. But he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?' So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, "The Lord has truly risen. He has been raised and has appeared to Simon." Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of the bread. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, once again we are blessed with a beautiful narrative of the Gospel for this third Sunday of Easter. It is the account of the two disciples on their journey to Emmaus. No? You know, if you try to look at the sort of geography as they were like how many miles away, no, from Jerusalem. Jerusalem was clearly the place of passion and crucifixion, and Emmaus, no, was another place far from Jerusalem. In fact, if you look at the etymology of the Semitic word, no, they say it means warm spring, no, and it is a place for relaxation. Kaya nga, sila'y lumalayo, nasa Jerusalem, siguro ang dami nilang dinaanan doon at medyo sila ay talagang balisa, no? Hindi nila alam ang nangyari, mangyayari, maraming nabalitaan. And basically, in a way, they wanted to escape from Jerusalem to go to Emmaus, so that perhaps they could just forget everything that happened, because they were at a loss. No, they did not know whether Christ truly rose from the dead as He promised. No, and they were still hurt by the fact that Jesus suffered and died, and they were disciples. No, I'd like to invite you, no, my dear brothers and sisters, because the two disciples, one was named Cleopas. The other was unnamed. And perhaps in this meditation, in our reflection, perhaps you could picture yourself as the other disciple entering that scene. Hindi nga sinabi, pwedeng yung disciple, babae, pwede ding lalaki. No? May nagsasabi, baka malay mo, asawa nga ni Cleopas yun. Hindi natin alam, no? Pero siguro pwedeng tayo yon on that journey. And you will see basically two experiences. The first experience is the experience of escape. No? Gusto nating mag-escape from Jerusalem dahil nga it was a negative, hurtful, bitter experience. And you know, when you are there, no, sort of wanting to escape, what are the emotions going on in your own life? I could spot three. It could be distress. It could be depression. It could be discouragement. No? Maganda nga makita ito, no? Kasi nung pa mo nagsimula nga ito at medyo tumatagal yung hashtag ECQ natin, yung quarantine period. Ito na po yung dinadaanan talaga natin, di ba? No? Tapos na-extend pa. And you know, we actually do not know what will happen given the COVID-19 crisis. We're all in this together, no? And how we wish we could just escape. How we wish we could just leave home or go to another world. Go to what we call a fantasy island, no? And forget everything, no? And it is because of many things, no? Many experiences. Alam naman po natin, no, marami na rin pong namatay at marami na rin pong mga naging biktima ng COVID-19. At alam din po natin, marami din nagkakasakit at seryoso po talaga itong virus na ito, kaya medyo kinakabahan tayo. No? This brings distress, depression, and discouragement to us. And you know, if there is one thing that given this COVID-19 crisis, makes the negative experience even graver is that, you know, just for those who whose loved one passed away, no? Isipin natin, no? We are in a quarantine period. It's an extraordinary experience. Pwedeng hindi mo kasama nung namatay ang mahal mo sa buhay. Hindi normal din yung pagbuburol. Extraordinary circumstances, like our dear Lola Tita here, she is not a COVID-19 patient or victim, but the circumstances tell us that we just had to do with what we have before we commit her, no, to the place of committal. Mahirap, no? To be far from your loved one at this time. And not to go through the, you know, sort of regular process of mourning and grieving. This really brings a lot of distress, depression, and discouragement. But then let's go to another experience. From escape comes the encounter. Jesus unassumingly joins the two disciples. No? He was like a traveling stranger who accompanied the two disciples on their journey of seemingly escape. No? And alam naman po natin yung naging tono ng conversation nila, no? But it's interesting that what the Lord did was something also very real, and if you will see, very real in our own experience of quarantine. No? What did the Lord do? First, no, He listened to them. Nakinig siya sa kanyang mga hinaing. Sa panangin, nangangailangan ka talaga ng listening ear, like, tsaka heart, di ba? Yung nakikinig para ilabas mo lang yung mga dinadaanan mo. Hindi mo pwedeng sarilinin, di ba? And then after listening, what happened? There was this explanation of Jesus. He told them, no, to go back to what Scripture said. We go back to the first reading, even the affirmation in the second reading of this prophecy about what will happen to the Lord. And then, when they were enlightened, what took place was they felt peace in their hearts. And they told the Lord, stay with us. Continue accompanying us. Sumama ka sa amin. And then, they ate the meal. They broke bread. And then, the great insight, were not our hearts burning when He was with us, perhaps breaking bread with us. At that time, they were at prayer. I would like to look at the three sort of negative experiences of distress, depression, and discouragement, and see how the encounter with the risen Lord brings a beautiful, striking alternative against distress, the invitation to discover the presence of the risen Lord. Against depression, the enlightenment brought about by discerning God's word. As Jesus told the disciples, did you not know? Do you not realize that this was prophesied in Scripture? And versus discouragement, as they were led to break bread, the devotion to pray with them, to experience the Eucharist. Maganda pong isipin na karanasan po natin ito, hindi ba? during this quarantine period, it's good to ask, how did you recognize Jesus Christ in your personal experience, in your home? Paano mo nakilala si Jesus sa hashtag ECQ? Magandang pag-isipan, hindi ho ba? Did you discover His presence in members of your family? Listening to you, accompanying you? Was this an experience also to open the Bible, to draw strength from God's Word, and discern that God's Word is leading us to a deeper relationship with God? And here now, online, in our social networks, was there greater or even deeper devotion in the breaking of the bread, in the celebration of the Eucharist? Alam niyo po, pakilala ko lang po ang aming chatita, lola tita. Ito po yung asawa ng kapatid ng aming lolo, no? At isang nakakatawag pansin po sa kanya, nung siya'y may malakas-lakas pa, no? Palagi po yung kasama sa aming mga reunion, sa aming mga gathering. Nandun lang, nakangiti. At kalimitan, nagbabalita pa nga, nagsasabi kung ano mga nangyayari sa aming pamilya. I would like to think that Chatita, Lola, Tita was like our risen Lord too, accompanying us, who have accompanied us in our journey of life. Bawat isa po sa atin, ganun din, di ba? Sa pamilya, sa magkakaibigan, sa pamayanan. It is the realization that Jesus Christ is alive in our own midst. I'd like to end with a sentence that I got from a spiritual writer. And this is what he wrote. I quote, "Easter occurs when we find in Jesus not a dead friend, but a living stranger." Let us open our eyes, our hearts, ourselves in the encounter with the risen Lord. We profess our faith in God. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Peter tells the crowd, "Out of ignorance, you put to death the author of life. Let us pray that we recognize Christ in others, that we always bring life, not death, to others." Let our response be, "Lord, hear our prayer."
That in order to reach out Christ, we also reach out to others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in order to share our food with Christ, we share our food with others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in seeing the wounds of others, we see the wounds in the hands and feet of Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we experience the joy and wonder of the presence of Christ as we recognize Him in others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the merciful God may deliver us from this COVID-19 pandemic, and that the frontliners, those who are assisting them, and those searching for the cure of this disease, may be blessed and be filled with the Holy Spirit of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are suffering because of this pandemic, physically, emotionally, and mentally, may find peace and consolation in Jesus forsaken and Mary desolate. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the souls of the faithful departed, especially Cristeta Marquez Vergara, and those who have died due to COVID-19, in the mercy of God, rest in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we include also the intentions that you plugged in our comments section in the FB page for those spoken and unspoken. Let us pray to the Lord. Heavenly Father, help us to be witnesses by our lives to the real presence of Christ in our world, the Christ who died for our sins and was raised from the dead for our salvation. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, to our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant Church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant us also the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is only right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed. And integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Thank you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring it to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, the unworthy and sinful Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Christetta, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may Mary to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you. Jesus, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
To those who are watching, please join us in praying the act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Look with kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please bear with our family, our relatives, We just have a short video to honor our beloved Cristeta, just for a few minutes, and then we will be doing the blessing of the remains, the ashes in the urn.
Worthy of every song we could ever sing. Worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. We live for you. Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes. Worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you.
We live for you.
Holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show.
Found.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Cristeta. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Let our response be, receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Saints of God, come to her aid. Come to meet her, angels of the Lord.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
Eternal rest grant unto her, Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon her.
Receive her soul and present her to God the Most High.
To you, O Lord, we commend the soul of Cristeta, your servant, in the sight of this world. She is now dead in your sight. May she live forever. Forgive whatever sins she committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant her everlasting peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our sister Cristeta, and we commit her body, her remains, to the earth. Ashes to ashes, dust to dust. The Lord bless her and keep her. The Lord make his face shine upon her and be gracious to her. The Lord lift up his countenance upon her and give her peace. Amen. The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.